scholar from Malaysia. And the title of that is 5G and Industrial Revolution 5 in Developing Economies. In other words, today we are going to hear a very important and revolutionary concept that is about to emerge globally. And this is the 5G network. There are a lot of apprehensions about 5G. There are also a lot of hope about 5G. And there's a lot of manipulation going on globally concerning 5G. Certain world powers do not like developing countries to have access to 5G. You could remember some last year, on the instructions of the United States, the managing director of a Chinese company, Huawei, was arrested in Canada on behalf of the United States, simply because that company was allowing certain developing countries, including Iran, to have access to the 5G platform. So this shows to you how important the 5G infrastructure is going to be. In this country, we have a lot of challenges, but we must join this revolutionary move so that our economy can also move to the right level. And only the right level, not necessarily the next level. Now, so that's why we invited a scholar from the International Islamic University in Malaysia, Professor Rashida Tolariwaji, who has been actively involved in research in this area. And we thought she should come here and share her views with our lecturers and students. I'm not sure if our curriculum at the moment in this polytechnic, I don't know that we have already integrated 5G into it. Maybe head of the department will talk about it. If they have not, then we must do that immediately. Even if we put it as an option, so that students will be able to pick a course in that area and be updated so that we'll be able to fit into the global economy. I always believe that we need to empower Nigerian youth with skills and knowledge so that even if they don't find jobs in Nigeria, with the right skills and the right knowledge, they can be able to fit into the global labor market. And they'll be able now to bring in income into Nigeria as foreign exchange. If you go to India and Egypt, these two countries, their major source of foreign exchange is diaspora. Indians who are working elsewhere. Egyptians, they have a lot of medical doctors in the Middle East. That's how they get their foreign exchange. Because they don't have oil like we have. So for that reason, you know, we here in Nigeria, we must empower our youth. We must upskill them so that they can now link to the global labor market and become source of revenue for Nigeria. We cannot do that if we don't update our curriculum. If we are not teaching 5G, then we must introduce it immediately. We are not going to wait for MBTE. We'll go ahead of the MBTE and introduce it so that our students can be able to. Let me not take much of your time. I must give you an apology. I may not stay until the end of the lecture, simply because the Governing Council of Kaduna Polytechnic are on ground. If I had to wait to see the chairman before I came for the lecture. And I'm going to start a meeting by 10:30. But I told you I'll be a little bit late. I'll stay until the lecture begins, and I will take my leave, and let me emphasize, without protocol. I'll simply slip out of the meeting. I don't take the protocol. Thank you very much, and I wish we are going to have a very successful and very informative lecture today, and I wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
Please,